50 years. Half a century has gone. In 50 years, MCC went from an organization recognized on a piece of paper to an example of hard work and success. MCC was hope. Now, it is a reality. 50 years ago, 6 individuals represented the community center. Now, there are 1,700. In 1969, Muslims in Chicago were as hidden as any elusive creature. Now, they are a contingency, a Chicago Muslim contingency, who proudly stand underneath the skyline of this magnificent city, sparkling, glittering, showered by happiness and tranquility through the blessings of God. But no, while the faces and places have changed, the name remains the same, MCC.
I think it has already established its legacy. You know, now the school is not just in one campus. When the school facility here was not sufficient for us anymore, and then there were more students on waiting list, we bought the Skokie campus, and that building has a capacity twice as much as the school capacity over here. So together we are now able to accommodate more than 700 students. So things are moving up.
In 5 decades, MCC is connected like it never had. It has made peace with institutions that once denied it recognition. It has come to embrace the civil servants of Chicago with admiration and respect.
They've invited us to their events and they come out to the community events. One of the things that I'm proud of is the fact that we've reached out to their community and gotten them active in village capacities. Saba Khan is on our zoning board. Mazur Khan is on the Police and Fire Commission. That dynamic has definitely shifted, and I think that's a good thing because I think it sets an example for other communities to be just embracing and get all, you know, congregations active. I just see it just getting better and better and the community getting tighter and tighter. If the whole world did that, we wouldn't have any of the problems we have.
MCC has become one with the city. A police officer gathering at the mosque, an involvement at a 4th of July parade, a celebration of a new Islamic school, a chance to break bread with curious strangers. But most importantly, it has made friends.
Churches, synagogue at the time around here, and other religious faith-based communities.
After Donald Trump surprisingly won the 2016 presidential election, scores of Morton Grove residents came by to give their vote of confidence and support to the Muslim Educational Center, knowing well another major backlash towards Muslims was possible. This was practically unheard of less than a decade before. Now as they look to the next 50 years, we can only wonder, what's next?
The first stage, I looked at MCC was in the sense of building some institutions. Then it became like, well, then after starting a mosque, let's have some, how do you educate the kids, right? So there was a first house, maybe Sunday school. Now then it became into another level and said, well, how do you get a full-time school? Now the third stage is, okay, how do we become also civically engaged in the community? So we're making sure that if someone's at a full-time school, some people might not be able to come to a full-time school, so we have a part-time program. But then we realized we have many kids now who have special needs. So we started a Saturday school for special needs. Now many of our elders who established all this, we need to build something for them. So now looking at it at another aspect where it's a real community center. Not just the mosque, but a community center where people could come of their own faith and even helping out other faiths.
In many ways, the patrons of MCC are a living embodiment of the city they represent. Hardworking, integrity, to be there for the community.
We welcome everybody to pray with us and be a part of the community, welcoming.
MCC has been an extension of my family, honestly. I've made many good friends here that have lasted a lifetime. I would encourage everybody to have a good relationship with your mosque and the community center. Somehow like build a relationship, be it service, be it just attending programs here, but do it consistently so that you can come back to it and find those same friendships and grow with those friends.
To help, challenge, and to build. This was the way of the prophet. Of all the prophets. This was the way of Muslims. This was the way of Chicago. As we close a chapter of a half century, one which started with the dreams of the pioneers, we look towards tomorrow for another chapter to be written, to be embraced, to be cherished, to be loved. and to know that we are all one.